Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car. Morello's wrapped up in all this.
Tommy?
Tough day.
We gotta
today,
keep
Tom.
A lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it. When Frank sees a LaPara, he'll know. The old ways work. Whatever it takes, Tom.
And now for the latest news. The Navy is today continuing its search for the remains of those brave souls lost aboard the airship USS Akron. The Akron was destroyed in a violent thunderstorm off the New Jersey coast Tuesday morning with the loss of 73 of 76 aboard. The disaster stands as the worst aviation accident on record. Yesterday, one of the survivors, Lieutenant Commander Herbert V. Wiley, spoke to members of the press and gave a brief account of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivors' rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus. President Roosevelt has described the loss of the Akron as a national disaster and said that he grieves with the wives and families of those lost and the nation. We will bring you more on the disaster and the Navy's search as we receive it. Thank you for listening. We return now to our scheduled programming.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
Depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
WLH Sports Report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Wisman Trophy back to Rock Heaven.
But doing so will be no easy task, as standing in his way is opposition captain, Jack Seidel.
Hey, Jack.
His solo home run in the bottom of the fifth inning of Game 5 turned events in favor of the Empire Bay team. Victory was canceled out by the Lancers in Game 6, and we now have a powder keg finale that is sure to have everyone glued to their radios. Can Bunny Smith bring it home for Lost Heaven, or will the Cannon's towering redhead have the final say? WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game of the Gold Series, and we hope you'll join us in wishing our boys well. And now, back to some of the latest musical numbers.
With music programming and up-to-the-minute news.
Everything okay?
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councilor Gilatti's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see French straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom, what's going on?
Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between them and more than a couple of nasty flare-ups in recent years. Of course, this occasion, more than any other, could prove feisty, what with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best current hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, the man mountain with the shock of red hair, and Lancers star, Bunny Smith. Speaking of Smith, he is jogging, I suppose you'd say, between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. By goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers. Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The cannons lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more. The reason the racers of the Lost Heaven Grand Prix use only Traego motor oil, and that's because only Traego makes engines perform at their maximum while guarding against wear and tear.
For you optimal need to get down here right away.
Officers downtown. Some fella near you is driving like a madman.
The mission of Lost Heaven Radio, our city's public service broadcaster, is to serve you. Start your day with WLH 570.
Abandoned search. Return to patrols.
Looks like the place. Take me to those account books, Frank.
And we return now to coverage what could be the final play of this game and the series between the Lost Heaven Lancers and the Empire Bay Cannons. A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by Swift Cola. When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors, Big Break Cigarettes and Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams. teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player at the core with promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least. Looks like he's putting one of the officials in his place or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion, and you just know that whatever happens, the crowd will be the first to tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the Gold Series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the bullpen. Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings. Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion.
Some kind of neat habit.
Or tired after his exertions this series, nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation. He's having a word with the umpire about something or other. What a strapping fella. 6'2", 195 pounds. If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write himself into the record books. And boy, oh boy, what that would mean to the people of Lost Heaven after such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons would have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Pass ball and strike. The big man thought he had it. Some speed on that ball. My goodness. It's fair to say Dougherty looks a little spooked. He was convinced he had it. His body language tells the tale.
Smith shit. Cool under pressure. They're taking you to the airport, Frank.
On his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no chance of hearing it as the noise of the crowd reaches fever pitch. Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate. This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory. A swing and a miss, and that's the winners! Lancers win!
Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
FBI.
Guy just flashed a badge at me and forced me out.
Hey, cop, how long is this gonna take?
Got a problem here. Oh yeah, I know where he is.
Hey,
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over, yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this. It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown. I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told them to get on a plane.
Go on, March, Alice. Get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
Damn you, Frank.
Sir.
Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
Beautiful day, huh?
Uh-huh.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
I need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Ah, yes. Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please, follow me.
I got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank again.
You're making my boys twitchy, Marku.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
It's a hell of a thing.
Look at these houses. Big yards, white picket fences. It's the American dream, eh, Tommy?
I suppose.
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Morell's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. But Paulie and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got on us.
Well, where's he holding?
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safecracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet Salvatore. He's fresh off the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and Arstuli says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
That him, boss?
Yeah, that's our guy. Salvatore, tutto bene?
Sì, grazie, Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Sì, ho capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, boss.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso. Per favore.
Parli almeno un po' di italiano? Il capo ti ha detto il piano?
I don't speak Italian.
Eccellente. Ah, fantastico.
No plan?
Yeah, the boss told me.
Please. Understand. Entriamo dal labirinto senza farci sentire né vedere. La cassaforte è dietro un dipinto al primo piano. Dammi un po' di tempo e lascia fare tutto a me. Quella cassaforte avrà sicuramente un allarme.
Yeah. This is gonna be a long night for the both of us.
Ah, Cristo santo.
Okay, my turn. Do what I do. Do not get caught.
Sì.
You gotta keep safe.
Safe? Sì. It's my job. Apro cassaforte. Open safe.
Christ. Okay. Radio. Let's listen to the radio.
Eccellente.
Hell of a view up here.
A volte questo paese è stupendo. Ecco.
Over wall. Labirinto.
What?
Vedrai.
Oh, a maze.
Sì, un labirinto.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
A quanto pare in America hanno il labirinto.
Nice evening for standing around, I guess. think that's all of them.
Salvatore! Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy! I hear!
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tommy!
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Forza! Vieni con me! Tommy! I hear!
Sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
C'è un'entrata. Open.
What kind of luck picker are you?
Look for a dipinto.
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio, hai capito?
Painting? You're saying it's behind the painting?
Sì, sì.
Okay, I understand.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check. Another here, Salvatore.
Sembra
only wall behind here.
Procuratore, piace la roba costosa.
Another here, Salvatore.
Non quello.
There's one.
Non quello.
Delightful.
What the hell are you doing here? Oh, burglars! Oh, help! We need help here!
Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do.
Shit. Be quick, Salvatore.
Pacienza, pacienza.
Nice work. Scusa.
A cura! Ed è collegato all'allarme!
What?
Inzappolato!
Doesn't matter! Come on, we need to get out of here!
Vai dietro, dietro!
They gotta be upstairs! Safe in this body! Salvatore, stay back! I'll deal with him.
Hear that?
Move into cover!
I get you first time.
Forza! Andiamocene! Che ti prende?
Yeah.
Grazie a Dio.
Salvatore, where do I take you now?
Home.
Yeah, where home?
Six and Naipol.
Okay, let's go.
Devo dirti una cosa. Al nostro prossimo lavoro penso io alla casaforte. Hai capito? Ci ho quasi rimesso la pelle in quella villa. Ed è tutta colpa tua. E impara almeno un po' di italiano per rispetto della nostra patria. È come parlare al mio cane, lo so. Ma Cristo, dovevo dirlo. Non farlo mai più. Mai più.
Ok, ok. Sure.
Good night.
Night.
The last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll. Get it out of here.
You heard him. Load it up.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss, any word on a job I pulled with Salvatore?
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah. And you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is south. And he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday.
But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm. And he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
He's got no love for Morello, I'll tell you that. Not like we got a lot of options here. We'll be cutting up the last beam pretty soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's the meat?
The big parking garage downtown.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab ass this time. You take Carlo and little Bill with you.
Sure thing, boss.
Once you have the truck, drive it back here.
We won't let you down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about it.
I know I don't. Tommy does that for me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Buona fortuna, boys.
Sam and little Bill said to meet him downtown. You okay, Carlo? Looking kind of like you shit yourself.
Ah, get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with a Dom than all of you've put together.
Sure, sure. Sat out on the road, wait till he's finished with his broad.
If you don't want me to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just, you got a face like you're being taken for an errand. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Why is Gates sell or Morello anyways?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in the nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more than a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. He'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Polly told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gone wrong.
Little Rusky behind the wheel, Tommy!
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Polly told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gone worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Careful! What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
I got trouble.
We got some heat, Tom.
The guy driving way over the speed limit.
You shit yourself.
Get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with a Dom than all you've put together.
Sure. Sat out on the road waiting till he's finished with his broad.
If you don't want me to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just get a face like you're being taken for an errand. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Where's Gates cell or Morello anyways?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in the nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more than a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. He'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom.
Little rusty behind the wheel, Tommy!
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Paulie told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gone worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
Do a lot of deals here. Parking attendant don't ask for much dough. Always closes up shop till I'm done.
Okay, we're good. Gates is waiting up on the top floor.
Come on, let's go!
Place seems clear so far.
Only people with cars are people with jobs. 9 to 5, place is deserted.
Well, we got jobs and we're here.
That kind of a job, sure.
Anything else we need to know about Gates, Bobby?
Only that he's got a bust-up nose and crates full of the good stuff.
Our kind of guy.
Our kind of guy. Park up over there.
Paulie, good to see you, pal.
Yeah, you too, Gates.
Well, I hope you all have good taste in whiskey.
I ain't really the expert here. Tommy.
Oh, yeah, it's fine. Your first payment. If the Don's impressed, he'll finance more runs.
And each one's gonna be bigger than the last. We're all gonna be rich, boys.
Well, we're always happy to do business with good folks like Don Salieri. Please, give him my regards.
Sure thing. Now we just gotta conclude this transaction.
Damn it, Paulie!
No! It's okay.
Oh. What? I told you, we gotta make it look like a proper robbery.
Damn thing's gonna be crooked by the time I'm done with this city.
Ah, don't worry, pal. With all the dough you're raking in, you're gonna be able to pay for a new one.
Watch out!
God damn it!
Balance together, Paulie!
God damn it!
your mouth off!
Gates took a bullet.
This ain't as bad as it looks. Now take the booze and get. My guys will come for me.
No, go, go, go! So long as you guys clear him out up ahead, I'll be safe here with the little guy.
Carlo, in the cab with me. You know you's dead. Tommy, check for more of them. This thing ain't over.
Come on, I'll back you up!
No, go, go, go! So long as you guys clear him out up ahead, I'll be safe here with the little guy.
More of them!
Gotta reload! Tommy, look out! They keep coming!
Get out of here!
Gotta reload!
see fire sprinklers up on the ceiling. We need to turn them on. There's gotta be a valve to turn someplace. Is there a way through this fence?
Keep moving, fellas. Keep the booze safe. I'm moving.
The trip wasn't over.
You see more, you shoot him.
See him!
Grab a set of wheels and watch my back.
Sure, Sam.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay.
Did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
Over here! I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts!
Thank you.
truck.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts! Lost them all.
Thank Christ for that. Let's head home. See what we got.
We got the booze. I mean, I know it didn't go to plan, but we got the booze.
Yeah. So tonight, me and you are gonna drink a bunch.
Did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts!
Two.
lost them all.
Thank Christ for that. Let's head home. See what we got.
We got the booze. I mean, I know it didn't go to plan, but we got the booze.
Yeah. So tonight, me and you are gonna drink a bunch of it.
I guess we earned that much.
Looks like a 38. Morello's boys caught up with you?
Yeah, boss. We took care of it.
What about the kid from Kentucky?
He took a slug to the shoulder, but he's a tough blocker. He and his crew dusted out as soon as we bumped off Morello's hatchet, man.
Getting shot will give Gates and his pop another reason to ice Morello out of the whiskey business.
Well, let's see if this hooch was worth all the trouble. Excellent. I'll work out the details with Papa Gates. But once we're running this Kentucky Brown, we'll be back in brass buttons. Good work, son. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of you. Saludo!
Saludo!
Sounds like Salieri was getting ready to make his move.
Working up to it, maybe. But then, Prohibition ended. And the bootlegging business got knocked on its ass. Oh, that fighting over booze meant next to nothing. It took us a few years to recover. But when we did bounce back, boy, it was something. We took what dough we had from the moonshine and Canadian whiskey and invested it into new records. Some of them even legal. Construction, restaurants, trucking, gambling. We branched out into everything. Except peddling dope. By 35, things were looking up. We had good money rolling in on the regular. I had a wife and daughter. Sam was running a club for the Don. Even Paulie had a few records of his own. Wasn't exactly happy, but what do you call it then?
Content.
Yeah, that was it. And Salieri, he finally starts talking about getting out of Morello's shadow. Maybe buying our own cops, our own politicians.
That's interesting. You think Salieri was sourcing highbinders in 34?
Maybe. Why?
Well, a few years back, a voice squad got a judge on solicitation of a minor. Once in the box, he started confessing all sorts of misbehaving, trying to get a deal. But he copped to taking kickbacks from Morello and your man Salieri. Playing him off one another, trying to goose the take. But once Morello found out, he threatened to bury the judge's kids on the beach. Still breathing, of course.
Christ. That was the missing piece.
How's that?
Morello was always winding us up. But he never did anything that might start an all-out war. Learning Salieri was building his own bench must have finally tipped his scales, because in 35, he hit us with both barrels. Of his face and pasted it
hey,
on his face.
Tommy.
Oh, hey, boss, what's going on?
I'm glad you're here.
There you go, boss.
I'm going to Pepe's for lunch, but Carlo called in sick. You up for a drive?
Sure, boss.
Bravo. I'm already starving. You got a piece on you?
Yeah. You think I'll need it?
You know how it is. Things with Morello have been a little quiet lately. Maybe it's just got me jumpy, is all.